Hello out there, YouTube Special Service Base Land, North America, South America, Africa, Europe, Middle East buddies. Shut it from the mountaintop. Shut it from the mountaintop. New prophecy from the throne room. Prophecy on politically correct is spiritually wrong. You know, last days, people don't want to hear the truth. They want to hear fables and tickle your ears and fairy tales. But Jesus Christ is life, truth, and resurrection. And they're using a racist word now. You know, anybody, if you disagree with somebody, you're a racist. No. This United States of America, our freedom of speech, our freedom of religion, you know, you could disagree agreeably. Just because you don't agree what the left believes, the commies and soldiers, that if you're a Christian, you want the truth. The last days, people won't see the truth. Jesus could stand in front of their face and be deceived, but they'll believe a lie and be damned. And, you know, just because we don't agree on the, we're on the same, Christians has a higher moral standard than the world. We've come out of the world. We're in the world, but not of the world. So, that's what's going on today. Everybody's trying to dumb everybody down, and the Christians stand on moral values, and the preachers in the pulpit, I'm talking to you preachers, that you have to keep this moral standard high. Our Governor J.B. Pritzker here in Illinois is lowering the moral standards with gambling, with legalizing pot, marijuana. It's going to make more addicts in gambling and potheads and taxing the people to death. He's going with the gay rights instead of, God is one man, one woman. It ain't two men or two women. That's the world. God's standard regarding that marriage is an institution. One man and one woman. And I pray for J.B. Pritzker, you know, and I pray for in Washington, D.C., you know, where the authority of power is. It's a battle of good and evil. In the last days, I call evil good and good is evil. But the Christians know what the moral standard is. And being politically correct, playing politics, playing mind games, playing games, is spiritually wrong. The Christians know what I'm talking about. And anyway, I'm going to read in the last days. Read your Bible. Say your prayers. Go to church. Pray that God believe in your last days. The great fall on the way. And there's a famine. And hearing the word of the Lord today. No, even in the churches, just now in the world, they're all screwed up. They don't know where the word of God is. There's a spiritual famine in the land, in the United States of America, in the world. And we're seeking God's will, His perfect will, His permissible will. What would Jesus do? That is the question today. We're going to be in the Holy Bible in Amos chapter 7. Oh, wait, let me get right. Amos chapter 8. Verses 11 from 13, short and sweet here today. Behold, the day comes, saith the Lord God, that I will send a famine in the land, not a famine of bread, nor a thirst for water, but the hearing of the words of the Lord. And they shall wander from sea to sea, from the north even to the east. They shall run to and fro to seek the word of the Lord, and shall not find it. In that day shall the fair virgins and young men faint for thirst. You know, we've had some hot summer in Pinkerville this year. We had a lot of days in the 90s. We had 100 heat indexes and 105 heat indexes, 110 heat indexes. And the corn, the spring, and even up to June, we had a lot of floods. And the farmers maybe a lot of corn would have put out. Maybe they're below 18% from last year yield. And the farmers, you know, some had to switch to soybeans. It was too late for the corn. But we know one thing. There is a famine by the spiritual word of God today. Don't let nobody tickle your ears or have fables or fairy tales. We stand on the word of God, this Bible. We stand on it. From Genesis to Revelation, we believe all of it, not part of it, some of it, but all of it. This is God's word, not my word. the scripture to defend itself. Illinois is in the crossroads, and Governor J.B. Pritzker, please don't come to the Coin State Fair, because there's some people here that don't like you, and I pray that you need to stay in Springfield, Chicago, for your safety. There's some crazy people out there. You know, I'm a Christian. I'm born again. I will do what's right. I pray for you, Governor J.B. Pritzker, but there's some really radical people here, Black Panthers, white supremacists, KKK. My advice to you, in love, not condemnation, guilt, do not come to Decoin, Illinois State Fair, for your safety reasons. I'm a man of God. I stand on the Bible, and I pray that you'll change J.B. Pritzker. Only the Lord God could change around and turn you back on the right way. Do away with your gambling. You lose your money. People be addicted. Do away with your pot. More people be addicted on marijuana. You know, do away with all these taxes. Illinois has the highest tax in the United States of America, especially Chicago. And the gas tax. You made too much increase because they're going to Indiana, they're going to Missouri, they're going to Iowa, they're going to Wisconsin. They're going to Kentucky, they're going to their places. I bought gas last week, $2.35 in Kentucky. Something's wrong with it. There's a difference of 50 cents a gallon, you know, per gallon gasoline. We have poor people in Southern Illinois, just survival. I run a food pantry. I've been doing it 22 years. It's tough out there, just survival. They don't have enough food to eat. People need help. Taxes drive people away. Lower the taxes, help the people. Bring Governor J.B. Pritzker, bring manufacturing jobs, bring jobs in. Marijuana won't stay the state of Illinois, or gambling won't stay the state of Illinois. All these taxes run business out. Lower the taxes, lower the corporate rates, lower the property taxes, lower all income, lower the taxes. If you do, Jehovah Jireh, the God of Israel, Jesus, Savior, Messiah, will provide. The Illinois, the Atlanta Lincoln will be on top again, not the bottom. We're in the worst of the 50th state. We're at the bottom, ranked 50th. It's up to you, J.B. Pritzker. It's in your, I pass the torch to you. You got to help Southern Illinois. You got to help Central Illinois. You got to help Northern Illinois. You got to help Chicago. By the people, for the people, of the people, Abraham Lincoln said. So, I love all you guys tonight. Me and Betty love you. And remember, this goes to J.B. Pritzker, Governor of the State of Illinois. Politically correct is spiritually wrong. J.B., if you do come down to Decoin, come by Pinkville, Illinois. I have a brand new Bible I'll give to you. I talk Bible to you. I pray with you. Illinois is being destroyed by the devil. J.B. Pritzker, Governor. Devil's in the details. The morality. I know, I don't know nothing about your past life. You know, if you're born again, I pray, you know, become a Christian. If you're Orthodox Jews, I don't know. Masonic Jews, I don't think you are. Or you wouldn't be doing the gambling. You wouldn't be doing the pot. You wouldn't be doing all these taxes. This is what syndicates do. This is what mafia do. This is what gangsters do. Governor J.B. Pritzker, come by. I give you a red carpet tour. We got soda, all the soda you can drink, all the sweets. You know, I'll show you the pantry. You know, I pray, Governor J.B. Pritzker, please turn around. Illinois, 3 years, I believe we could be, we're in a valley shadow decision. Well, knock, knock, knock on the heaven door. Illinois is about ready to go under. Illinois is about ready to go bankrupt. You got to solve the pension problem. We got a real problem there, Governor J.B. Pritzker. But anyway, that's my prophecy from this room. Politically correct is spiritually wrong. And because you disagree with somebody, I don't agree with you, Governor J.B., but I love you. I love the sinner, I don't love the sin. And come by and see me, baby. We love you today. Have a good day. Amen. Shalom. Over and out. 10-4. Sayonara. Part of you fans say, adios amigo to the next video. Thank you, YouTube, for this video. We've been doing it 10 years. Time is short. You know, I'm slowly riding into the sunset. I'm 66 years old now. I don't have many days ahead of me. Jesus returning soon. I don't think we got 3-4 years left. These are the last days. Paul is trying to take a trouble. But keep your eyes on Jesus, the author and finisher of faith. Jesus Christ, Savior, Messiah, King of Kings, and Lord of Lords. He's Alpha, Omega. And he loves you. He's the Redeemer. And he got great plans for you. He's the Son of God. He's Jesus Christ, Son of the Living God. So I love you all. Have a good day. Anybody be praying for you, you be praying for you. Us, lift your hands to heaven. Praise his holy name. Jesus returning soon. Get ready. Ladies and gentlemen, crank up the church phone. We're going home to heaven soon. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Everything in that book, praise the Lord. We don't praise you. Those stones are crying, praise you. Thank you, Jesus.